Our generation is pretty much screwed with social media at the tip of our fingers. We're all addicted. And it's crazy. Why are you still scrolling, man? You know it's bad for you. You know that it's just cheap pleasure. You're screwing up your brain. So why are you still scrolling? And the other day, we were eating lunch with a group of friends, and there's this one dude, and someone asked a question, right? And we were all answering, and then this guy did not answer. He was glued to his phone, like literally like this. His neck was at a 90 degree angle. We asked him the question, he just didn't respond. He didn't even look up. Like, oh my goodness, our generation is actually screwed. So that's why I want to make this video. God has an amazing plan for your life, and it's not sitting there on the couch scrolling. I'll tell you that. Fair enough. The average person spends 4 hours a day on their phone. Add this up to the average life expectancy in men 80 years old. 11 years of your life will literally be wasted on the device you're holding right now, or the device on your desk, or wherever your phone is. 11 years. That is insane amount of time. Insane amount of time where you could be doing something else. You take actual steps to decrease your screen time. Think of the progress you could gain from doing something else other than scrolling on your phone. As the end of high school draws near, we need to be prepared for the real world, or for college, you know what I'm saying? If we're sitting there in our room scrolling, what habits are we developing? What do we have good going for us if we're just sitting on our phone all day, staying up hours and hours into the night, and spending hours and hours of the day just on our phone doing absolutely nothing beneficial or productive, man? We need to develop good habits. All scrolling is doing for you is it's screwing up your attention span and screwing up the chemicals inside your brain. It's nurturing you to not want to pay attention, not want to do hard things. It's nurturing you just to see something you enjoy. And if you don't, you're scrolling right past it. How is this going to benefit you if, let's say, you're in college and you have to sit down and complete a task that will take multiple hours? But if your brain is so used to something that will please you in 30 seconds, less than 30 seconds, how are you going to get this job done? Because the other guy, your competition, he knows that social media is screwing up his brain, and he knows he will get ahead if he gets off of that. He knows that training his brain by meditating, he will have a longer attention span that someone like you who is still scrolling will not have. And he will get it done. He will have the edge, and he will do things that you want to do. Imagine this. You're given a task by your employer, right? And he gives you to the end of the day. This is all hypothetical. Let's say he gives you to the end of the day to complete the task. But since your attention span is so screwed, you don't get it done and you get fired. All right. It's an extreme case, but you know, it could happen. What if it's something that he is depending on you that will really, you know, promote the business, keep the business going, and you don't get it done, right? Versus the other guy who understands that he needs to sit down and get the task done. He has good habits. He's developed good habits. He gets it done. There is between you and him. He's not scrolling. You're scrolling. Your attention span is screwed, while his is not. This is all social media is doing to you. It's screwing your attention span. Second, you need to find your purpose in life. Your purpose is not sitting there scrolling. Get off the phone. Find something you love, and then help others while doing something you love. I hope this video helped. Scrolling is doing you no good. Keep fighting. I believe in you, bro, and stay strong. Stay hydrated.